joined by Congress Neta Supriya Srinath. Now, Supriya, my question to you would be, because you're still a fairly new politician, when you look at a senior veteran like the career of Pranab Mukherjee, what would younger politicians want to pick up from that? Today, yes, he's not there physically with us, but he's left too much of a career span for people to learn from.
No, indeed, and I pay my respect and homage and tribute to Pranabda. I do not know if you know my background. I may be new to politics, but I have been an economic journalist for about 20 over years, in which I have covered Mr. Mukherjee as in his various ministries. And in fact, I always called him Pranabda even after he became the President of India. Of course, protocol required us to call him sir, but when behind closed doors, it was always a relationship that I shared, a personal bond. I have actually been to his village where he went for puja every year without fail, thrice. And I can tell you, I think the one thing that he completely stands out for is the anecdotes, is the amount of history he knew, is the vast knowledge that he has. He had an elephantine memory. He knew so much about so many events and things. So sitting with him was almost a lesson, not just in life, but a lesson in history itself. And I think one of the things that I would want to get from him is the big consensus maker he was. The fact that he stood up to every challenge and faced it, and the fact that he had friends across party lines. You know, there were no enemies. I think in this hyper-polarized world of politics, he did not have political enemies. Yes, we all have opponents, and I think that's the one thing that Indian politicians need to pick up from him. But as far as I'm concerned, I think it's a huge personal loss for me as well, because I remember when I joined politics, when my father passed away, when I was made a spokesperson, at every step of the way he wanted to meet me, he counseled me. Yes. And I think I'm going to miss that a lot.
And Supriya, I understand how people who have known him personally would be feeling right now. But you know, one of the few politicians to have been a young finance minister and then external affairs, then defense. This is a rare achievement to have had that span in different areas and to handle it so well, handle it in tough times when the country was going through turmoil.
Oh, absolutely. With such a lan, I mean, I still remember in 2008 when the global financial crisis hit us, India was completely untouched. I mean, one of the reasons was because Pranab Mukherjee was at the helm. Of course, later our fiscal deficit and things went up, but the reality was that we did not see the crisis that we are seeing today, and it was because of his adept leadership. As far as the other ministries are concerned, which is what I said, you know, he could wear so many hats because of the exposure and the experience he brought to public life. I had always seen him with books. I don't know if junior reporters and editors will even know this, that he used to meet media at 1:30 at night. You know, he used to have people visit him at that hour, and he used to write his diary every day, even while he was meeting people. And he always very proudly said, when I am gone, my daughter is going to publish my work and my diary. I hope Sharmishtha does that. My heart goes out to both her and her two brothers and the entire family, some of whom I've grown to know closely and I'm very fond of.
Supriya, thank you so much for giving us your perspective and your experiences about having met Pranab Mukherjee, having known him. As I stay with these visuals, while I cannot exactly see from the PPE kit, but I would like to guess that's the son, Abhijit Mukherjee, and performing the last rites.
Hi everyone, Preeti Chaudhary here. Hope you like this video. For latest news and analysis, like and subscribe to the India Today YouTube channel. And don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated. Thank you for watching.